Today I have a very, very cool audio spectrum vector tutorial for you to design for yourself in Adobe Illustrator. Also, I'm going to review and show you guys a very cool resource called Portfoliobox. They're sponsoring today's video, and at the end of the tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to use it, so you can make a very cool portfolio for yourself in a matter of minutes. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. Today's video is based around a suggestion by a subscriber on how to design an audio spectrum vector in Adobe Illustrator. And like I said at the very end of the video, I'm going to review and show you guys quickly how to use Portfoliobox. So if you guys want to have control over your own portfolio online and you want to do it in a quick and easy manner, Portfoliobox might be your answer. Portfoliobox is offering my subscribers and my viewers 10% off, linked in the description below. So check it out and use Portfoliobox to make your own super cool portfolio today. The first thing we need to do in Illustrator for our audio spectrum vector design is to make a circle with the ellipse tool. You can press L on your keyboard to locate it, or you can go to the toolbar. Make a black circle by holding down Shift, and then add a gradient to the stroke. You can take your time modifying your gradient in the gradient window, but try and get a nice blend between various vibrant and bright colours. I've sped up this part of the tutorial, as I did spend quite a long time choosing the gradient for my audio spectrum vector. So increase the stroke weight, and then if need be, make the circle smaller so you can see what you're doing on the canvas. The trick here is to increase the stroke until the black midsection disappears. So once you've done that, open the gradient window and choose this option here, which will set the stroke around the circle like so. Pretty cool, huh? A quick tip, it's going to help you guys in this tutorial if you turn on the scale stroke options in Illustrator. So when you change the size of the circle, the stroke will resize in unison. Move the circle off to one side because we're going to use that later. Make another circle, but this time use a light grey colour. Press Command or Control R to open up your rulers and bring in guides that intersect directly through the middle of your circle, vertically and horizontally. It's very important that these lines are perfectly aligned with the circle, so zoom in and take your time to set them up correctly. If you can't see your guides, right-click on the artboard and make them visible. So once you've set up the guides, select the circle and lock it in place so it doesn't move around. Elect to use a black stroke with no fill, and press P on your keyboard to access the pen tool. Draw a small line like I'm doing here, and hold down Shift to make sure it's perfectly vertical. You can then press Shift and W at the same time to access the Width tool, and carefully adjust the line so it's slightly thicker at the top. Take your time to create a nice contrast between the top and the bottom, but make sure it's not too different. Once you're happy, select the line and press R on your keyboard to access the Rotate tool. You need to drag the blue icon all the way down to the midsection of the circle on your guide intersection. It needs to be placed perfectly, so once it is placed, click once, then hold down the Alt Option key and click again. In the new window, type in 1.8 and then Preview. make sure the new line will not touch the original line, and then click copy. You then need to hold down Command or Control plus D to repeat the process all the way around the circle. You can right click the canvas and hide the guides because we don't need them anymore. This part can be tedious, but it is essential. Press A to access the direct selection tool, and then click and drag the anchor point of one of the lines to change the length. You must make sure that it follows the original path. So you need to go ahead and do this for every single line on your vector design, and make sure that everything is aligned all the way around the circle. I'm going to go ahead and skip this part of the video, because it's going to take too long for you to see, so I'll see you again soon. So your design should look something like mine here. You can click and drag to select all of the small lines, and then change the stroke weight. You want to have a nice gap between each of the lines, and make sure they're not touching. Then, you need to drag the lines off to one side and outline the stroke. Open up the Pathfinder window and unite them all together as one shape. We're close to the finishing line for today's vector design. With the line selected, create a compound path. Then resize the circle and bring the lines over the top, in a way that you think is going to look good for your design. So when you're ready, select both the lines and the circle, and then right click and create clipping mask. Next, unlock everything, and then we're going to want to create a black shape and send it to the back of the design. Lock this shape in place because it will act as a backdrop for your audio spectrum design. On the circle, flick the fill over to a stroke and then add the same gradient as we did before. You can use the option in the gradient window to generate a gradient all the way around the circle. Touch to add to our design, then I have that quick look at the tutorial on the portfolio box at the very end of the video. So stay tuned for that if you're interested in making a cool portfolio for your work. With the line section of the design selected, go up to Effect, Stylize and Outer Glow. I'm going to use a pinky purple colour for mine, but you can experiment with different colours. You can then click Preview to see the outcome, and then click OK to generate. And there you have it, your audio spectrum design. You can now add the outer glow to other aspects of your design, like I've done here on my logo and the inner circle. So next, a brief look at Portfoliobox. So like I said, you can check in the description below for a link to get 10% off a fully fledged account with Portfoliobox. I made a quick portfolio in around an hour and a half to show you guys how it works and how easy it is. The user interface is very easy to follow, and it took me a few minutes to get used to, but there are guides I'm going to show you later that do help. You create page by page by selecting the page you want to make and then click Create. Each page type has different layout options, and if you upgrade to Pro status, you can unlock multiple options. So once you've created the page, you can start adding content in a very easy manner. You have control over things such as the pixel size, and you simply locate your image and then upload it. Then click Insert Image. This is going into my logo section of my portfolio. In the bottom corner of the screen, you can see a Learn button that I found very useful. It will show you what you need to do in a very logical order. It will present red icons for you to follow and click, which helps a whole lot. So here's my final portfolio design, which I did rush for the purposes of this video, but as you can see, I have social media icons in the bottom left. I probably should edit those to make them more visible, but it's super easy to link your social media, by the way. You've accessed your pages at the top menu, and one of the coolest pages you can add is the Instagram page, which all you need to do is log into Instagram via their page, and it's going to automatically add all of your Instagram posts that you've ever made. Then there's my About page, which has an email link. And there are so many ways to customize your portfolio. It's a very easy and clean way to make your portfolio website. So yeah, check out the link in the description for 10% off and get exposure on your designs with Portfoliobox. Also quickly, Ochi Magazine asked me to do an interview with them, and you can check that out in the description below because there's a link to that interview. So there is today's tutorial on how to design an audio spectrum vector in Adobe Illustrator. Let me know in the comment section below what you thought of this video, and also leave a like if you did enjoy it. Share my content on social media if you do find it useful, and remember to subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content just like today's video. Have a great day everyone, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.